What was, like, your favorite experience working on the film?
Whenever the seafood came. It was something that everybody was so excited. Like, this is making the seafood taste come in my mouth. It was something that everyone liked to have there because it's something that we know how to eat and dig into and eat and chew and do whatever we need to do with it. So it was something that I loved, the movie loved, and the camera guy loved.
It's funny you say that because when I saw the movie and I saw the scene with the seafood and you, like, eating the crab, I actually went out and had seafood the night of the movie. I was so hungry for seafood after watching that movie.
Yeah, seafood is every part.
You eat a lot in the movie, too.
Yes.
You do? Were you ever like, ugh, I have to eat another crab? Or were you always just like...
No, I was like...
You were like, bring it
to me! Bring it to me!
That's great. So, let's talk a little bit the rest of the cast. How did you meet Dwight Henry?
The first day we went on set, they actually brought him and told him about how I told the other guys how I told them, no, you're fired. like, no, you can't get this part because I just don't feel comfortable with you. So he was just the only, like, I think, I don't know, but I think, and he was the only one that he could have got the part. It was something that he wanted to try, so he came with a bag of sweets and he gave it to me. And I was like, what is in this bag? So I actually go in the box and I took out what was in the bag and it was sweets and like I smelled sweets. So I opened the box. All I saw was brownies, cookies, buttermilk drops, brownies, anything that was called a sweet was in there. And I was like, yeah, and I just wanted it. So
he won you over with brownies.
And cookies.
And cookies. And buttermilk drops. I just had one of his buttermilk drops for the first time.
They are delicious.
I had three. I'm in a food coma right now. They were delicious. What would you tell me to do in New Orleans? Like, what was the first thing I should do if I ever go to New Orleans? Again with the seafood. All right. That's fair enough.
And just go explore the restaurants.
What's your favorite area? Do you have a favorite part to go hang out?
Golden Corral. And Chuck E. Cheese. And Pinocchio's and the skating rink. All right,
I will definitely go to the Golden Corral in New Orleans. That'll be my first stop.
They have ribs and pizza.
And a chocolate waterfall.
How do you know about it?
I have my sources. I've done my research.
Mm-hmm.
So I know that like one of the big first stops you did on the tour was
France.
In Cannes.
Well, actually, the first one I did was in Sundance.
Sundance, yeah.
Whatever you really want to go with.
All the way back to the beginning. Yeah. So how was that? Was that fun? Like, what was that experience like?
That was actually something that I wouldn't expect because, like, you live in home and, like, you just fall asleep. You wake up, you're on the plane, then you fall asleep again because you're, like, just going on vacation. Fall asleep again, you wake up, you're in France. You're like, how the heck did I get to France? And it's something that you don't expect. Because at your age, you're only so young, and you just go there, you just close your eyes, you're at the airport, close your eyes again, you're on the airplane, close your eyes again. Next thing you know, you're just seeing different people talking in French, and it's just crazy, so you just have to go along with it.
All right, Quvenzhané, thank you so much. This was really funny, and it was a real pleasure to interview you.